In today's show, Houston, we have a problem. Four words that brought the world to a standstill as a billion people shared the anguish of space engineers as they strive to bring three astronauts safely back to Earth from their crippled Apollo 13 spacecraft. A stellar explosion of such intense magnitude that it produces a massive burst of energy that is more than 10 times that of the lifetime output of our sun. This explosive phenomenon is called a supernova. And we look at the fossil fuel-burning machines of the Industrial Revolution, which for over 100 years have had a significant effect on our atmosphere. April the 13th, 1970, and the mood of space engineers at NASA's Houston Control Center could only be described as relaxed. The Apollo 13 mission had successfully hurtled into space from Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center at 2:13 p.m. on April the 11th. And now the flight was going as planned, with astronauts James A. Lovell Jr., the commander, John L. Swigert Jr., the Command Module Pilot, and Fred W. Hayes Jr., Lunar Module Pilot, entertaining the ground crew with the observation that it was rather odd to be floating in their space capsule whilst listening to the theme music from 2001. Amidst the routine instructions, Jack Luzma, at the time heading the ground crew, calls on Swigert to stir up the cryo tanks, a reference to the cryogenic oxygen tanks. Nothing appears to be unduly abnormal. Swigert responds, okay, stand by.